This module is just a short introduction to rate laws. So we'll use the same reaction that we did to introduce rates of reaction, the dissociation of gaseous nitrogen dioxide. Now, the thing is, most chemical reactions to some extent are reversible, meaning that the reverse reaction does occur. So the reverse reaction of this is just if we flip it around. Instead of dissociating nitrogen dioxide, we combine nitrogen monoxide and oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. Now, if we have a reaction vessel where this is happening, then the rate, how fast the nitrogen dioxide disappears, is going to depend on how fast it dissociates and on how fast it reforms. It gets a little bit complicated. So what we do to make it simple is say, okay, let's set it up so that we don't have any nitrogen monoxide and oxygen, or very little, recombining to form nitrogen dioxide. If the almost all that's happening is nitrogen dioxide is dissociating, then it makes life simpler. Well, when is that? You know, when's that going to be? It's going to be right in the beginning. If we start out, we take our reaction vessel, and we don't have any nitrogen monoxide or oxygen in there, and we add some nitrogen dioxide, bring it to whatever temperature, 300 Celsius or whatever, and let it start dissociating. Right at that point, the initial rate, okay, is only going to depend upon how much nitrogen dioxide there is, not this stuff. So under those circumstances, we can say this, that the rate is going to be proportional to the concentration of the reactant, and it might be to some power. And constant proportionality we'll call K, rate constant. And this is true if the reverse reaction is negligible, which it will be if we do it right at the beginning where there is very little of the products around to reform the reactant. So this is a form of the rate law. We're going to work with this. Now, remember we said that the rate could be, we could write it as the negative change in the concentration of the reactant over the change in time. We also said it's equal to, remember the negative here is because it's a reactant, so it's disappearing, its change in concentration is negative, this makes it a positive rate, and we could also set it equal to K, concentration of nitrogen dioxide raised to power X. But we could also, we did in the last module, write the rate as the change in concentration of a product that's formed, say oxygen. But because the balanced equation, okay, we can see that two nitrogen dioxide dissociate for every one oxygen that forms. We know that the change in concentration of nitrogen dioxide over time will be twice that of the change in concentration of oxygen. So we could write another rate law, rate prime, okay, this prime means it's different than the one we wrote before, which is equal to just the change in the concentration of oxygen over time. And that'll be equal to some different constant called K prime. Again, you know, at the initial rate will be only involved concentration of nitrogen dioxide to the power X, which, by the way, this power right here, we don't know it. We can't just figure it out by looking at the balanced equation. The only way to really find this exponent out is to do an experiment, do some experiments. And this is, you know, the whole field of kinetics, chemical kinetics. Now this exponent could be anything, could be an integer, could be a fraction, what have you. In this course, we're gonna deal with situations where this power is almost always a simple whole number. It could be 0, 1, or 2. Those are the ones we deal with. Although just remember, it could be anything. So now the rate, okay, that we wrote initially involving negative delta concentration of NO2 over time is equal to K, NO2X. It's twice, okay, it's the rate, okay, if we write it in terms of the concentration, to change in concentration of nitrogen dioxide, that would be twice this rate up here, which means that if we write the rate law, K, NO2X is equal to 2K prime, NO2X. So what to get out of this is that we have to be careful about how we define the rate. And so throughout kinetics, we're always going to want to be careful how we define the rate, you know, in terms like this or like this. All right, so the rate laws that we've seen so far, we call them rate laws. Sometimes, you know, they're called differential rate laws. And the rate for differential rate laws, the ones we've seen so far, the rate depends upon the concentration. It's a function of the concentration of the reactant or the reactants. Now, there are these things called integrated rate laws, which are related to the differential rate laws by an integration. But these depend upon time. The rate changes over time. So we're going to look at both of these throughout this chapter. There we go.